Serialization. Yes, you heard it correct. In this session, we are going to discuss how to use serialization in REST Assured. So it's very likely that you could have a requirement that you have a POJO class, means plain old Java object, and you need to send it to the API call. To do that, we need to serialize it in our REST Assured, and this process is referred as a serialization. So before going to move ahead, what we did in earlier session, so let's say this is my post request and we are passing our body using map object. So instead of map object, what we are going to do, we are going to build a POJO class. So POJO means plain old Java object. So here we are going to automate this request and we are going to perform a serialization operation. So for that, first we need to create a POJO class. So how we can create? So in POJO class, we are going to use these three fields: ID, title, and author. So let me copy this body, and here I have created a class, and in this I am going to create a POJO. So to create the POJO, I have to initialize this three string value. Private ID I am considering as an int ID. Then I should have title, private string title, and we have to use author as well. So private string author. Like this, we need to initialize our variable. After that, our ID is intelligent enough, so we need to just simply right click and we need to create a getters and setters for that. So before that, I am going to create a constructor. So I need to click on constructor using field, and I am going to select all these fields. So generate. So it is going to give me a constructor. Super is not required as of now. After that, we need to create a getter and setter. So in some cases, we need to create a getters or setters or both. It depends on our requirement. So however, in this our case, I am going to create a getter and setter both. So again, we need to go to source, generate getters and setters, and I have to select all these fields. So I'm going to select all and generate. So this is my getters and setter. And one more thing, I'm going to create a toString method. So generate toString method. So it will give me response in that particular, or let's say I wanted to print entire object, so it is going to print in that particular format. Generate. So this is my toString method. So here what I am going to write, I am going to use this keyword, this dot id, this dot title, and this dot author. So we have created a POJO. So while creating POJO, we need to understand one more thing. So initializing the variable will be a private, because this is another concept of encapsulation, and we need to take care of these things. Let's say we have created the private fields, so we can control it using our getters and setter method. So fields should have getters, setters, or both. Even we can create an argument constructor or no arg constructor, and fields are accessed by only getters and setters or constructor. That's why we are going to create these fields as a private. Now I'm going to create my test class. So before that, let me go to my request. So I'm going to postman. So in postman, we can see here, this is my request and we are passing these three parameters. So let me generate one resource. And before, you need to make sure your server is up and running. So I'm sending. So if I'm sending, I'm getting this error because inserted failed because of duplicate ID. But my server is up and running. I'm getting 500 server error. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create one more test class for that. So public class, and I'm going to give a name as a serialization test. Test, and I'm going to generate one class. So here I'm going to define one test method using testng annotation, public void serialization test. And in this, we have to write our API. So REST assured dot given dot when, first we need to pass our headers. So headers, in headers we are passing our default header, which contains content type, which is application/json. So we have created API builders, which will be inside our API config, and I have header config. So I am going to use this. So First, I need to create an object of this class. So in this, I am going to create an object, header config. Header is equal to new header config, and using this reference variable, I am going to call that method. So head dot default header. So using this, I am going to get default header, which is application type dot. Now we have to pass the body. So how we can pass the body? So simply we need to call that POJO class. So to do that, we need to first create an object of our POJO class. So this is my POJO class, post API POJO. So using this class name, I have to create an object of that. So again, post POJO, my POJO is equal to new post POJO, and I have to pass all this value. So ID I have to pass as an int. So I have given the int value. So let's say I am passing some generic value or some random value, and then I have to pass title here. So let's say I am giving a title as a serialization test, and author will be Nishant. So whatever value you have defined in POJO class, let's say you have defined for int, string and string. So same value you need to pass there. So I have to pass as a body, and this POJO object I have to pass as a body dot post, and we need to pass our API endpoint. So which I have mentioned in API path dot post request, create post. So this is our request, which is done, and I'm storing as a response, and reference variable will be response. So let me print this. If I'm going to print sysout response dot get body as string dot as string method. So let me run my test, run testng test. So I'm getting 403 error because we haven't extend our base class. We need to extend base class, extend base test, and we need to pass virtual argument as well. So I'm going to run it for dev environment. So let me go to the argument. I have to select the particular test. Let's say I'm going to select serialization test, argument -denv is equal to dev, and let me run this. So now successfully we are able to run our test, and we are getting this data. So now using that POJO, we can access the data as well. So what we can do, whatever data we have passed using this constructor, we can print those data as well. So POJO dot get author, so it will give me author. POJO dot get ID, it will give me ID, and POJO dot get title, so it will print title. And if you want to see what body we are passing, then we can print our entire object as well. Sysout dot POJO dot toString, so it will print our entire response. So let me run it again. Same argument, same test, and I'm going to run my test again. Yes, so we can see here, this is my POJO, and our test is failed because ID is duplicate. Now one more thing, let's say we are passing in body, we are passing ID, title or author. So is it case sensitive or not? So let's check that as well. So I'm going to my POJO class, and instead of using title in a small case, I am going to use T in capital. So let's say you did mistake by any chance, then what will happen? So I have to change in my entire POJO class title, whatever I have used title, I have to change the value, and same thing I have to change the value of author as well. So I am going to change value for author, and we are going to run our request, and we'll see if it is case sensitive or not. So I am going to update my ID here. Instead of 22, I am going to use 27 some random, or 287 some random ID, and let me run my test again. So I am going to give name as a case sensitive. So we'll get to know, right, and run. So my test is running. This is my POJO, and it is still giving me a value, and I am able to run my test. So it has updated the value ID, title and string. So however, we have used here the normal or basic POJOs, but what if in real time example we have complex POJO? So in this case we need to go with the POJO or not, and the thing is, in which case serialization will help. Let's say we are running are tested sequentially in this manner. Let's say we have created one resource, and after that we need to use that resource multiple time. In this case, we can go with the POJO. So let's say I've created my first test for valid data, and I'm going to execute my single another test, and I'm going to use the same ID, or I'm going to, after post request, I'm going to validate the data. I have already created the data or not, or my request has created the data or not. To verify that, I'm going to run my get request. To fetch data, I need to use this ID. So in this case, we can go with the POJO class. Otherwise, you can go with the normal map object. So it's choice based on the requirement. In next session, we are going to discuss how to deal with the complex POJO. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching the video.